A very warm welcome to one and all present here, and I'm delighted to see everyone here. And to those who do not know who I am, I'm Dr. Sandhya Vashisht from the Department of Health Sciences, Chitkara School of Health Sciences. And to start with why I took this topic, I need to tell you about myself. I am a qualified and a registered Ayurvedic practitioner, that is, I've done my BAMS from Chandigarh. And thereafter, I did my post-graduation in hospital management. So I have a background of Ayurveda and have been practicing it for quite some time, dedicatedly practiced Ayurveda for around 4 years. And it is a delight for me to share some knowledge which might be very, very useful if we understand the particular topic which I have chosen for this particular talk today. And I believe by the end of my talk, we would be really benefited and would understand the concept of Prakriti. So I think we can start with it now. Also to mention here that this particular topic, which I would be starting with Ayurveda and insight to know your Prakriti and know yourself, I would firstly like to know the audience. And I have a small poll question for all of you so as to understand what is your knowledge of Ayurveda, or is it there, or is it entirely a new topic to you, a new thing to hear about? So I'm just presenting a poll question here and you would be able to see it onto your screens. You may please vote. And the question says, do you have any prior knowledge or awareness about Ayurveda? Still waiting for few of you to reply to the poll question. Another half a minute which you have. So here are the results. And it is really delighted to see that 63% of you know about Ayurveda and have some prior knowledge about it. Thank you for answering the question. And with this, we also move to another question of ours. That is the second question. And I would like to know that what is your source of information about Ayurveda? You would be able to see it onto your screens. Is this source because of the practice in the family, like in your grandparents have been practicing it and is a everyday word in the family? And or is the origin from Google, through some books, through some internet, or mostly what we see nowadays, it is a lot of being shared and forwarded through WhatsApp messages. Okay, we are getting a lot of responses for this one as well. Okay, so it seems like a number of people have knowledge of Ayurveda. That is, okay, we are just waiting for another 2-3 minutes for everybody to answer this. We have 30 seconds more. Okay, that's it, I believe. And we are sharing the results with you. And as you can see it onto your screen, internet and Google and also through books, that is a very, very big source of information for Ayurveda. And second in line is what it is being practiced in the family. So definitely, it is a very, very common word in our family. So thank you for answering this particular question as well. So as I understand, all of us are quite aware. Most of the audience who are listening to this, they are quite aware of what Ayurveda is. And definitely whatsoever it is, all of us have heard about it, all of us, somewhere or the other, we practice it. But today I would be talking exactly what Ayurveda says and what is its aim basically. So if I just move towards the aim of Ayurveda, it says swasthasya swasthya rakshanam aturasya vikar prashamnam cha. That means I would also be using a bit of a Hindi because the essence of Ayurveda can best be understood with Sanskrit and Hindi. So to explain some things, I believe Hindi is the best language which can express a lot of things in the bestest ways it can. So Ayurveda ka prayojan hai ki swasth vyakti ke swasth ko kaise bachaya ja sake और स्वस्थ व्यक्ति किस तरह से हमेशा स्वस्थ रहे. तो अगर हम देखें कि पहला जो इसका पार्ट है श्लोक का वो यही कहता है कि आप बीमार ही ना पड़े, हमेशा ही स्वस्थ तरीके से जीवन जिए. और दूसरा इसका पार्ट है विकारस्य प्रशमनम. तो अगर कोई विकार या कोई रोग हो जाता है तो उससे कैसे बचा जाए. तो इसके बाद हम आगे चलते हैं जहां पर हम बात करेंगे एक कॉन्सेप्ट जो बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है जिसे पंच महाभूत और त्रिदोष कहा जाता है. पंच महाभूत शायद आप लोग जो थोड़ा सा स्पिरिचुअली भी अगर अलाइंड है और कुछ स्पिरिचुअल लिटरेचर पढ़ते हैं तो वो शायद जानते होंगे कि जो भी बना है पृथ्वी में या जो भी हमारा शरीर है, अगेन आई विल बी यूजिंग अ श्लोक हियर, यत पिंडे तत् ब्रह्मांडे और तत् ब्रह्मांडे यत पिंडे, मतलब कि जो भी शरीर में है हमारे वही हमारे ब्रह्मांड में भी है और जो कुछ हमारे ब्रह्मांड में है दैट इज वट एवर देयर इज इन द एंटायर यूनिवर्स एंड इकोसिस्टम, ऑल ऑफ दैट इज देयर इन द बॉडी इटसेल्फ एंड वट एवर देयर इज इन द बॉडी इट इज ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट अराउंड अस. सो ये जो पांच तत्व हैं जिसको हम कहते हैं आकाश वायु पृथ्वी जल और अग्नि, ये सारे जो पांच तत्व हैं इन्हीं से हमारा यूनिवर्स भी बना है और शरीर भी. इन्हीं पांचों तत्वों के साथ रिलेटेड है हमारे तीन गुण जो हमारे शरीर को बनाते हैं या त्रिदोष जिनको कहते हैं, नॉट बेसिकली गुणास, दैट इज अ साइकोलॉजिकल आई वुड से एलिमेंट जिनको हम गुण कहते हैं. वेर एज जो हमारे बॉडी के एलिमेंट्स हैं जिनसे हमारा मोस्ट ऑफ द बॉडी जो है कंट्रोल्ड रहती है, दैट इज द वात पित्त एंड कफ. तो ये जो तीन हमारे पास त्रिदोष हैं इन्हीं से ही, इन्हीं का ही बैलेंस जो है वो बॉडी में सारे ही चेंजेस लाता है. अगर हम इसको समझें कि जैसे आपके पास एक बीम बैलेंस है तो इस बीम बैलेंस में तीन चीजें पड़ी हैं अलग अलग बैलेंसेस में और उन्हीं के बैलेंस पे ऊपर नीचे होने पर जो है कुछ डिजीजेस डेवलप होते हैं. जब ये तीनों ही अपने बैलेंस्ड और नॉर्मल फेज में रहते हैं तो आपकी बेस्टेस्ट हेल्थ रहती है. ठीक है, इसी के साथ अगर आप स्क्रीन पे देखें कुछ हमने राजसिक सात्विक और तामसिक शब्द भी लिखे हैं. इनका मतलब है कि इन्हीं गुणों से या फिर जो आपके पास ये जो गुण है जो मानसिक गुण जिनको हम कहते हैं सात्विक राजविक और राजसिक और तामसिक, ये भी हमारे वात पित्त और कफ से रिलेटेड है कहीं ना कहीं. तो मैं इनको आपको बाद में एक्सप्लेन करूंगी. और अगर हम आगे इस पिक्चर पे देखें तो मैं यहाँ पर ये बताना चाह रही हूँ आपको कि जो वात पित्त कफ हमारे शरीर में है ये ना ही सिर्फ हमारे शरीर में एक एक वेरिएशन इसकी होती है. जैसे कि मैं आपको एग्जांपल दूं तो अगर हम चाइल्डहुड अपना देखें या बचपन देखें 9-10 साल की उम्र तक हमारे शरीर में ऑटोमेटिकली कफ गुण का जो या कफ एलिमेंट है जो वो प्रेडोमिनेंट रहता है. तो अगर मैं थोड़ा एक्सप्लेन करूं क्योंकि यहाँ पर बहुत सारे लोगों की भ्रांति रहती है कि वात को वो हवा से ही सिर्फ सिग्निफाई करते हैं या कफ को सोच लेते हैं कि वो कुछ जो है वो कफ से रिलेटेड चीज है, तो ऐसा बिल्कुल नहीं है. ये वो एलिमेंट्स हैं या वो एनर्जीज हैं जो बॉडी में सारे फंक्शंस को रिलेट करती है. फॉर एग्जांपल मैं बात करूं वात की, तो हमारे शरीर में जो भी चीज चलत्व है जो चलायमान है, जैसे कि इवन कि हमारे जो शरीर में रक्त का संचार हो रहा है या फिर नर्व इंडक्शन है, आपकी नर्व इम्पल्स की इंडक्शन है, तो वो भी वात के कारण ही है. कोई चीज जो है एक तरफ से दूसरी तरफ जा रही है या खाने के पाचन में जब हमारा फूड जो है वो माउथ से इसोफेगस और फिर इंटेस्टाइन्स में मूव कर रहा है तो उसकी चलायमानता में भी वात का रोल है. अगर मैं पित्त की बात करूं तो वो पित्त जो है वो एलिमेंट है शरीर में जो अग्नि प्रदान करता है या तेज प्रदान करता है. हमारी सारी जो सिक्रीशंस हैं बॉडी में या जो पाचन का काम है वो सारा पित्त का रोल है. Whereas if we talk about कफ, तो ये वो कफ वाला जो है ये वो शलेश्मिक जो है secretions है, greasy या oily या लचीलापन जिनमें है और ये तीनों ही बहुत important है. तो कफ वो वाला element है जो heaviness देता है body में, body को build करता है. है ना, और ग्रोथ के लिए हेल्पफुल है, जिसमें कुछ ऐसा गुण है जो हैवीनेस क्रिएट होती है जिसकी वजह से. तो ये तीनों ही गुण जो है बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. ऐसा नहीं है कि एक होगा तो वही चीज चाहिए हमको, नहीं, तीनों ही बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. बिकॉज एक होलिस्टिक एक बॉडी की अगर हम फंक्शनिंग की बात करें तो तीनों के अपने अपने कुछ कुछ स्पेसिफिक रोल्स हैं और उसको फंक्शन करने के लिए इंपॉर्टेंट है. बट कहाँ फर्क आ जाता है कि हमारा जो जीवन है ना, लाइफ है, एक जन्म से लेकर मृत्यु तक, तो उसमें भी इनका बहुत रोल है. अगर हम बात करें अपने बाल्यकाल की या छोटे होते हुए, तो 9-10 साल की उम्र तक, क्योंकि डेवलपमेंटल स्टेज है, तो उसमें कफ की जो वृत्ति है वो सबसे ज्यादा है, तो उस टाइम वो जरूरी है, इंपॉर्टेंट है, वो डेवलपमेंट हो रही है बॉडी की. बैरस जैसे ही हम लोग यूथ में पहुंचते हैं, उस समय ज्यादा प्रिडोमिनेंट पित्त हो जाता है शरीर में, और जैसे जैसे एजिंग स्टार्ट होती है वात का गुण बढ़ जाता है. तो ये तो हो गया एक जो नॉर्मल कोर्स हमारी लाइफ का रहता है. उसी की तरह जैसे मैंने आपको कहा, जो सब कुछ शरीर में हो रहा है वो हमारे पास, हमारे वातावरण में और हमारे आसपास भी हो रहा है. तो इसकी भी एक वेरिएशन या साइकिल रहती है कि जो सुबह से शाम तक बॉडी में जो इनका, अगर आप देखें स्क्रीन पे जो लेफ्ट साइड पे आपको दिख रहा है, उसमें कुछ नंबर्स दे रखे हैं जिसमें कि टाइम मेंशन्ड है. तो टाइम मेंशन होने का मतलब ये है कि हमारी बॉडी में किस समय पे कौन से पर्टिकुलर त्रिदोष की जो है प्रेडोमिनेंस रहेगी, और उसी दोष के कारण जो प्रेडोमिनेंस है, हम लोग काफी ज्यादा कोई कोई पर्टिकुलर एक्टिविटीज में ज्यादा सक्रिय होते हैं. जैसे जिस समय दोपहर का समय है, 10 से 2 बजे के बीच का, अगर आप देखें जहां एक येलो कलर का ट्रायंगल आपको शो हो रहा है, तो वो एक ऐसा समय है जहां पर हम मोस्ट एक्टिव रहते हैं, हमारा डाइजेशन भी अच्छा होता है उस समय. जो खाना अच्छे से, हम अगर हैवी मील भी ले रहे हैं, दैट गेट्स रियली इजिली डाइजेस्टेड. वेरेज अगर हम उसी को ही देखें 6 PM to 10 PM के पास, तो वो हमारा कफ जो है बॉडी में प्रेडोमिनेंट हो जाता है. और दैट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट रीजन कि 10 बजे या फिर आइडियली तो कहा जाता है, जिस तरह से हमारे आसपास भी देखा जाता है, कि जैसे ही सूर्य अस्त हो जाए उस समय पे, उससे पहले भोजन करके इंसान को सो जाना चाहिए. क्योंकि वो सो जाना चाहिए, वो और ऑब्वियसली जो सर्कैडियन आपकी रिदम है बॉडी की, वो भी आपको वही कहती है कि ऐसा ही ड्यूरनल वेरिएशन चलनी चाहिए, और बॉडी उसको सपोर्ट करती है. Whereas, because आजकल हमने अपना रूटीन इस तरह का बना दिया है, एंड उस चीज को हम लोग अपने अकॉर्डिंग फ्रेम कर लेते हैं, एंड वी आर स्लीपिंग एट लेट एंड ऑल दैट थिंग. बट बॉडी जरूर याद दिलाती है कि आपको नींद आ रही है, जो एक उसका आइडियल टाइम होना चाहिए, जबकि बॉडी में कफ की जो मात्रा है, जो कफ का जो आपका त्रिदोष है, वो ज्यादा प्रेडोमिनेंट होता है. तो ये थोड़ा सा एक आइडिया देने के लिए आपको. और उसी तरह से राइट साइड पे जो आपको पिक्चर दिख रही है, वो आपका टॉक करती है कि जो आपके वेरियस समर सीजन है, मॉनसून है, ऑटम है, उसमें भी ये दोष वेरिएट करते हैं, कहीं पर ज्यादा होते हैं और कहीं पर कम होते हैं. तो इनका हम बाद में, इनका हमें इंपॉर्टेंस पड़ेगी जब हमें अपनी प्रकृति के बारे में पता चल जाएगा, और हमें अपनी प्रकृति को बैलेंस करने के लिए अपने आसपास अपना जो है ईयरली साइकिल से भी ध्यान रखना होगा, और हमें जो ड्यूरनल साइकिल है, दिन रात की जो साइकिल है, उससे भी हमें हेल्प मिल पाएगी. With this, I would also like to put some light upon a very good shloka here mentioned by Sushrut Sanhita, and this particularly talks about health, what health is, and it would really interest all of you to know that when we talk about the World Health Organization's definition of health, it is very, very synchronous with what we used to have it 5,000 years ago when Rishi Sushruta had mentioned this. So he says, sam doshah sam agnish sam dhatu malah kriyah prasann atmendriya manah swasthya iti abhidhiyate. मतलब कि इसका मतलब सिंपल सा ये है कि हमारे शरीर में कुछ दोष हैं, जिनका मैंने बात की है, वातपित्त कफ, कई प्रकार की अग्नियां हैं, ठीक है जी, जिनमें से एक पाचक अग्नि भी होती है, बहुत सारी धातुएं हैं जो कि साथ होती हैं, रस रक्त मांस मेद अस्थि मज्जा शुक्र, और 3 तरह के मल भी होते हैं. तो जब ये चारों चीजें अपने बैलेंस में है, मतलब कि ये चारों जो आप कह लीजिए बॉडीली जो है एक पर्सन की कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स हैं, जब ये सारे एक इक्विलिब्रियम में है, एंड अलोंग विद दैट आत्मा इंद्रिया मन, ये तीनों भी जब हैप्पी हैं, दे आर कंटेंट, देन एन इंडिविजुअल इज सेड टू बी हैप्पी. सो दिस इज व्हाट वाज सेड long, long back. And similar is the definition, if I talk about WHO, WHO says health is a complete state of physical, mental and social well-being, and not merely the absence of a disease or infirmity. So both these definitions are very, very synchronizing with each other, and this is what we have from the ancient text. Now we talk about the major topic of today's discussion, which is there, and I'll be talking about Prakriti. And before we start this, I would also like to request all of you to have a pen and a paper also with you. And with the next slide, I'll also let you know that you need to prepare a table as well, so that while we go through the various points of Prakriti, you can just mark the values and the scores for yourself. So just arrange for a pen and a paper or a diary or a notebook alongside. Thank you. Now I start with the topic that is majorly concerning Prakriti and what Prakriti is. It is the Ayurvedic reference and which stands to be an individual's natural constitution, which is fixed at the time of creation. That means at the time of conception, an individual or a child or a human being's Prakriti is predefined. This includes both the physical and physiological constitution, and the three doshas are mainly which are there, which form this Prakriti, and also their imbalance would result into illness. So this is what Prakriti is basically, and as you can see it onto the screen, if you could just scribble a rough table onto your notebook, we would be able to move ahead. And if I can just explain, there are these four columns, and there would be 24 rows which you are supposed to prepare. 24 rows and four columns. If you can see onto the very first column, very first row, it says V, P and K. These three stands for Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So what are we supposed to do when we are moving ahead with the points? I would be explaining few points under these three categories, and which of you find correlates to you the most, you know. It has to be an unbiased approach. It has to be very much knowing yourself, right? And it needs to be not what you should be. It should be what you are actually, you know. So just take that into consideration, so that whatever you are marking and giving scores about, that is the exact I would say, the judgment which is there. We'll move next. So I need to start with the particular points which are there. If you can see it onto the screen, firstly, we'll be talking about the body frame and the body weight. So these would be the categories are three here, that is under Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So somebody who has a very thin frame and a low body weight would fall under the Vata category. Somebody who has a moderate or a medium body weight under Pitta. And similarly, if a person is broad built, has a the shoulders are broad and things like that, and is also overweight, would fall under Kapha Prakriti. Second is the type and color of the hair. That would also decide into which category you go. Dry and thin hair, which are prone to breaking also. The second would be the soft, early graying and brownish hair, light colored hair, that is. Then thick and oily and dark colored hair. So you can just keep on marking yourself as one point wherever you feel you have that particular, you fall into the particular column of yours. Then we come to the skin type and complexion. If the skin is very dry and rough, you know, you also need to take care that definitely in the season of winters, it would be dry, but in other seasons as well, if it is dry and throughout it is dry, then that is Vata. So just take care of that note also. Second point is again under Pitta, that is soft, thin and tendency for the acne and freckles, which is there. So it is, if it is very, very much, then it is under the Pitta category. And then lastly, we have if the skin is thick, that is the thickness of the skin is more, it is oily, it stays cool, thanda rehta ho shareer zyada, hai na, and clear complexion ho. There is no acne or freckles or things like that. So then you fall into the Kapha Prakriti. The size and color of the teeth would be under Vata, protruding, big gums are emaciated, and there are a lot of cavities as well. Another is moderate in size and yellowish teeth, soft gums. And lastly, Kapha, strong and white teeth, which are there. Then we have your nails also. The nails, in case they are very brittle, they break very easily. They are dry and you often get cracks in them. So Vata, if they're soft and pinkish, then Pitta, and strong and thick and shiny under Kapha Prakriti. Eyeballs, if we talk very small eyeballs, dull and dry eyes would come under the Vata. If the eyes are sharp and shiny, then Pitta Prakriti. If the eyes are very big, attractive and thick eyelashes then cover. Mental activity also, because as I mentioned, this is the Prakriti of a person. It takes into account both physical as well as mental abilities. If you are quick and restless, that means Vat. If the person is smart, intelligent and intellect is good and is also but aggressive, so with the Prakriti. And if the person is calm and stable and always throughout, even in case of some ups and downs in the life, stays stable, then Kapha Prakriti. Memory and grasping power. If it is quick and grasping, quick grasping is there but poor retention, right? So that is Vata Prakriti. If the grasping is moderate but retains whatever is there. But if there is low or slow grasping power but good retention is there, then it is Kapha Prakriti. I hope all of you have marked yourself for all these points up till now. So I'll be moving ahead onto the next slide then. Okay. The next slide talks about the bowel movement, that is the defecation, right? So if the feces are dry and hard and the person often suffers from constipation, then Vata Prakriti. If the stool is soft and loose, and often the Pitta Prakriti people, even if they have milk at the night, they might just get a loose stool in the morning. So that is also a very significant feature of such people. And with the Kapha Prakriti people, if they have slightest of some something which is, you know, laxative type, they might just get loose motions, right? So that is a particular a pattern of all these people. And then the sleep pattern, it is interrupted and very less in case of Vat people, then moderate in Pitta, and lazy and sleepy in case of Kapha Prakriti. If we talk about the communication pace, which is there, talkative. These are Vata people are very, very talkative. They talk a lot, but then definitely the quality of communication is not that good. Then another is Pitta Prakriti. They are very sharp, incisive communication, and analytical abilities are very good. Kapha Prakriti is very less vocal, but they have good communication skill. If we talk about wealth, so the Vata Prakriti people, they spend without thinking much, and they're spendthrift, whereas Pitta Prakriti, they save but also spend on valuable things. If we talk about Kapha, they prefer more of the savings. So you keep on judging yourself quickly on all the parameters. Another point is social relations. For Vata Prakriti people, there are very less friends and they also prefer solitude. Whereas for Pitta Prakriti people, they are good in making friends also. Okay? Good number of friends they have. Then we talk about Kapha Prakriti. They love to socialize and relationships are also long lasting. If we talk about the walking pace, so you can also judge yourself from how you walk. If you are walking, if you usually walk very quickly and with fast and long steps, you are from the Vata Prakriti. If the walk is average and steady, then Pitta Prakriti. And if it is very slow with short steps and you walk at your own pace and easily, then it is Kapha Prakriti. If the 15th point talks about the body energy, becomes low in the evening and fatigue after very less work. So that is a very significant feature of Vata Prakriti. If we talk about the Pitta Prakriti, they are moderately energized and they get tired after medium work. Whereas if we talk about Kapha Prakriti people, they are very energetic and they really don't get very easily fatigued. The eating habits next is about eat quickly and without chewing properly. Basically, there is a lot of haste in the life. So they quickly eat and without even chewing it properly. If we talk about Pitta Prakriti, they eat at a moderate speed. Whereas in case of the Kapha Prakriti, they chew properly and they take their own pace and time for that. And this is the last sheet which needs to be evaluated for all of you on your own. It talks about the body temperature, which is less than normal. That is, hands and feet, they are mostly cold. Okay, even in the summer season, they might be cold. Okay, and the Pitta Prakriti more than normal, and face and the forehead remains quite hot. Then Kapha Prakriti, normal hands and feet, and a slightly cold. And a slightly cold can also be a slightly sweaty as well, right? Another point is intolerance of the weather conditions. So the Vata Prakriti people, or where the Vata Gun or the Dosha is very, very predominant, they are very intolerant to the cold environment or cold temperature. whereas Pitta Prakriti, they are intolerant to heat. And in case of Kaphaj Prakriti, they are both tolerant to heat as well as cold. If we talk about the joints of the various kind of people, what kind of characteristics the joints show, in case of Vata Prakriti, the joints are very weak and they make noise while they are moving or they are stretching themselves. So that is a very typical feature of them. Whereas in case of Pitta Prakriti, healthy joints are there with optimum strength. Whereas in case of Kaphaj Prakriti people, there are joints which are very, I would say, healthy and heavy weight bearing joints are there. And also to remember that with, as I mentioned, with the pace of life also, all these would change. So in case it is in an older age, so definitely the joints would be more weak. But if it is more than usual, which should happen with the progression of age, then definitely it is related to a particular type of a prakriti. Reaction under adverse conditions, mostly the Vata Prakriti, they are quite anxious about things and they worry a lot and erratic or irritable behavior is noticed. Whereas in Pitta Prakriti people, there is a lot of anger and aggression which they show. On to normal, adverse situations wherein a particular kind of a reaction has to be shown. In case of Kaphaj Prakriti people, they are very calm and very soothing personality and they might just go into depression, but they are not aggressive, right? So that is how they have their nature. Then we talk about the nature. The Vata Prakriti people, they are very fearful and moody and very unpredictable. You never know what they can say and what they can do at the next moment. Pitta Prakriti people are very aggressive and jealous and impatient as well, and ambitious also. And Kaphaj Prakriti people, again, they're very calm and very, very, I would say, very, very settled in their behavior and choices and attached, and they're very likable people by all. Okay. And the next point is about mood. The Vata Prakriti changes a lot. As I said, they're very erratic in their behavior and have frequent mood swings. Whereas in Pitta Prakriti, the mood doesn't change that easily, it slowly changes. Whereas the Kaphaj Prakriti people, they're highly stable and constant in their behavior. Quality of voice, in case of Vata people, it is very, very rough and might be the communication, which I would say here is, it might just not be that good enough. And the words are also broken, or they might just be fumbling while speaking. So that could also be one of the characteristics. Pitta Prakriti people speak very fast, they are commanding and they have a good hold on communication. And again, with Kaphaj Prakriti, they are very, very soft spoken, but with a deep and a very, very good communication which they have, and the quality of voice. Lastly, the last point here to evaluate yourself is pace of performing of work. So the Vataj people, they really are very, very quick in performing work and very, very responsive. Immediately, if you are given a work, you quickly do it, right? And the Pitaj Prakriti people have a moderate pace and they more of move towards the understanding of the task and then accomplishing it. Whereas the Kaphaj Prakriti people, very, very slowly they understand things, then they think about it, reflect on it, and then they start working on it. So these are the three kind of prakritis and the characteristics which these particular, I would say, doshas, these exhibit in a particular person's body. So I believe that all of you must have given points to yourself, and the next step here is to actually total all these into each column. So you can just total what the Vata Prakriti column you've got and what is your total score in the Vata Prakriti. What is the total score under the Pitta, and what is the total score under the Kaphaj Prakriti? So I just give you another 1 minute to do that quickly. And once you have done that, you can put it into the chat box if you like so. And we will also have a poll question next, so that we can understand what your Prakriti is. So before we move to the poll, I'll just be letting you know the various Prakritis which are there. So we have Ekal Prakriti also, wherein a particular dosha is highly predominant. That is, out of the three, maybe one is highly predominant. So the total score here would be 24, okay? And out of that 24, it could be that Vataj is quite high, right? And the Pitta and Kapha are very low. Because you know, it would not be that 24 you get in Vata or 24 you get in Pitta. Because as I mentioned earlier also, there is a balance of all three of them. It cannot be onto one side only, but then definitely a predominance of one of them would there be, right? So if it is showing to you, the results are showing that more than 40%, that is a 9 or so, is in a particular 9 and above, that is in a particular, I would say, dosha, then that is a predominant one, right? So three prakritis are vataj, pittaj and kafaj. Then we have dvandaj prakriti. That means two particular dosha, that is two of them would be more predominant. That is vata also would be predominant and pitta would also be predominant, right? So that is another. So with that we have 1 to 8. Okay, so you would like to see slide 1 to 8. I am just moving to that as well. Okay, so while I'm talking, I'll quickly show all these to you. And Dvandaj Prakriti would be wherein 2 out of all these 3 would be more predominant, right? The score of 2 would be near about same. For example, you get 7 in one and you get 8 in another, or 9 in one and 9 in another. So that would be 2 particular doshas predominating your personality. And there might just be somebody who has a comparatively equal score in all. So that is also some Prakriti, which has been mentioned by a lot of acharyas, wherein they say that that prakriti has quite a lot of balance in them, right? So you just go by what you have experienced and what you understand about yourself according to all these points. I'm moving on to another. If you want me to stay onto this slide, just let me know, or I'll move to the other. If some of you are still giving yourself, evaluating yourself, I'll move to the other so that you can quickly just have a look at this one as well and mark yourself. Okay, so I can see Sumit sir has mentioned, and he says that he has Pittaj 11 and Kafaj 10. That means, somebody wants us to stay onto the very first slide. So we'll just go back. Okay, we'll just stay here. So Sumit sir was mentioning that he had scored in two particular, sir has scored in Pith 11 and in Kafaj it is 10. So sir, your Prakriti is Pith Kafaj. So that is the two doshas are more predominant, and Vat is also there, whereas it is significantly a very less role. Right, so Pitta Kafaj. So once we understand all these prakritis, we'll be moving to another question here. That is, once we have understood all this, what is the benefit? So the benefit is to simply understand that we have a lifestyle and we have a diet and we have a plan for ourselves, wherein we do not let these particular doshas go out of balance. So balance is basically the key to all this, right? So I hope all of you have marked yourself, and with this we would also have another poll question. So I'll just quickly move to the poll question so that we can know. Either you can do it here, or we can just put a poll question to all of you to understand what your Prakriti is. So you would be able to see on the screen, there are these 7 kind of prakritis, right? So if it is very, very predominant, one particular dosha is predominant, you can mark vataj, whereas it is pith, or if it shows that kafaj is very, very predominant, out of all the score is very high and it is not relative or comparable to any other, then the ekal prakriti can be there. Whereas for the others, there can be a dvandaj, and it might just be some prakriti. Kindly mark your prakriti so that it is very easy for you to understand which kind of a food and which kind of a lifestyle would best suit for you. Okay, we are still waiting for another few seconds so that the others can also give their particular response and we can know what the prakritis are. So if you've seen all these points, we get a clear idea of what kind of a prakriti can be there. So now the poll is ending and we would be going on to the results, what the results speak. So we have Vatish prakriti also with us. We have Pith prakriti as well, people, Kafaj prakriti, and Vata Pithaj prakriti is also there. There are four amongst the audience, and 17% are with the Kafaj. A similar percentage is for all the three others. Thank you for giving your response. And with this, we would move ahead to understand this particular activity and to benefit out of it. So these are the prakritis I had talked about. And now we talk about something which is most beneficial. So for Vataj Prakriti, the predominance basically is about the space and the air, Mahabhut, which we had talked about, the Pancha Mahabhut. So in their personality, basically air and space, that is Akash and Vayu, is predominating. So they should abstain themselves from fasting, and then strenuous exercise is also not good for them. Working in very, very cold environment is also not good. And preferably these kind of personalities, they do not like much of a cold, and do not like would also mean that they develop some kind of a problem. Maybe they develop some body pain or things like that. So they really don't like a lot of cold environment. And Vata type should also try to stay in warm and humid conditions and very quiet and safe and comfortable environment. So that is good for them to go. Then oil baths, regularity in work, because as we had mentioned, there is a bit of a erratic behavior also. So it is good if they plan their work and they have a good routine for themselves. So that would be very, very good for them. Good food, and rather it should be good and hot and very, very freshly prepared food, which would be good for them. And beverages also, especially hot beverages, would be good for their body type. And consistent peace and quietness are healing for the Vataj type. In particular, gentle and relaxing massages with sesame oil, that is tel ka tel, and classical music, dance and meditation, these are very, very recommended for such people. This is a long, long list for the favorable foods which Vataj Prakriti can go in for, and I think I can share this particular presentation with all of you so that you can have a look at what kind of a particular diet would be good for you. You know, I'll just be mentioning very few of them. For example, wheat is good. Then we have til, what I just mentioned. Then moong dal, then black grams is good. All the milk products, milk, then butter, ghee, cheese, all are good. Oil also in any form is good for their body, not just for edible oil. Here oil would be more of for massage, you know, because they are prone to dryness. And then we have this white gourd, then we have ginger, and there is a long list which I have mentioned here for various oils, vegetables, fruits and spices. So all of you can just go through this list once I share it with you, and you can just figure out what is best for you. If we move next, what should be reduced into the diet, then we have foods which are cold, dry, and they have astringent properties. So again, there is I just picked a few of them. Sprouts would not be much good. Then the very first picture is the kulath dal. People from some hilly areas, I think they would be getting a better idea of it. And kulath is also used quite often in those places. So that is also not much favorable for such people. Then singhara is also not much favorable. The next is walnut. Not much of a walnut, but also please remember when I'm saying a not, it doesn't mean entirely a no to everything. It means a moderation or a very less consumption of these things, right? So it is always advised to have a very, very balanced diet, and what always the great acharyas have mentioned is the use of swabuddhi. Swabuddhi मतलब अपना दिमाग खुद से इस्तेमाल करके कि आपको कौन सी ऐसी चीज है जो आपको बॉडी में आपको जो है तंग करती है, which really gives you a problem. So just avoid that. That is a simple and a basic principle which is there, right? So the things are here mentioned. I'll move to the pittaj prakriti and the ideal environment for pittaj individuals is cool and a dry, right? So because their prakriti is more predominant with agni and jal, right? So contrary to both these things, the things should be practiced. Such as if I say there would be things like sweet scents would be good for them, sweet things also, then oil and ghee, all those things, these would be good for the pittaj prakriti people. And a daily of a 10 to 20 minutes of a gentle self massage with warm coconut oil with will cool the heat of the pitta basically. And also there are people who suffer because of the pittaj prakriti a lot of with acidity, so they can practice a bit of a desi ghee in their diet. So probably they'll find some rest to that as well. So it might just seem ki ghee se kya hoga, desi ghee se kya hoga, but then it is pitta shamak. And just keep watch that desi ghee should be actually from cows, milk, that ghee should be used. So this is about the pittaj prakriti people, and the steps can be taken right from the childhood once it is understood that the particular child is more of a pittaj prakriti. So that would really save a lot of things that can be done. Then this is a big list which is the favored foods. That is, you can see onto the screen all these things somewhere or the others, which we all usually use a word as tasir. In sab cheezon ki tasir thandi hai. पके हुए आम में और कच्चे आम में बहुत फर्क होता है. पके हुए अंगूरों में और कच्चे अंगूरों में बहुत फर्क होता है, क्योंकि विद पैसेज ऑफ टाइम उनमें जो गुण का चेंज आता है, उनमें जो उनकी आप कह लीजिए नेचर में चेंज आता है, दैट डायरेक्टली अफेक्ट्स अ ह्यूमन बीइंग. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स विच शुड बी गुड फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर पित्तज प्रकृति पर्सन. Foods to be reduced by the pittaj prakriti, again I have used a particular picture for this. To be reduced, kulath again pitt badhati hai, maki dal pitt badhati hai, a lot of saag also, it might just create a problem for pittaj prakriti people. If you just see, I have in this picture also I have mentioned some spices, whereas in this picture also I have mentioned spices. So if you can understand why it is favored and also to be reduced in a very very moderate form, the spices should be used, but are good. Just as if you say, अगर कहीं हवन की अग्नि जल रही हो, उस हवन की अग्नि में थोड़ा थोड़ा सा घी डाला जाए तो वो अग्नि अच्छे से प्रज्वलित रहती है. अगर उसमें आप बहुत सारा घी डाल दें तो वो बुझ जाती है. सो सिमिलर इज द केस ऑफ यूजिंग स्पाइसेस. सो इफ मॉडरेट एंड अ गुड अमाउंट ऑफ स्पाइसेस आर यूज्ड फॉर दीज पीपल, दे रियली गेट एनर्जाइज्ड एंड दे कैन परफॉर्म रियली वेल इन देयर ऑल देयर टास्क. But if they are used more, then that particular pittaj gun would aggravate and cause problems and illness. Similarly, if I talk about the kaphaj prakriti people, if a person is kaphaj prakriti, then also he should be encouraged to participate in sports, because definitely the gun which predominates here is it is more of prithvi and jal. So both are heavy, right? So the body would be heavy. So it would be good for such people to be more of physically active and participate in sports. And have a natural tendency for reduced movement, because if we just read about and we have talked about the prakriti, there would be a bit of a onto the laziness, right? So that is their actually type, but they should be advised to go in for more of a body movement and indulge in more of physical activity. Inculcation of habits that lead to the kaphaj prakriti person to participate in sports from childhood will lead to a healthier life and would prevent from chronic diseases as well. So this is really good if they practice it and they do not develop obesity, right? So this is again kaphaj prakriti people, what they would be really really favored. How would that be favored? So these are a few things which I have mentioned. Corn, then you can see the oats are there, then masoor dal, almonds, dry ginger. So dry ginger and fresh ginger, again both these are different in their tasir, right? कि उसकी ठंडी तासीर है कि गर्म, सो इसकी गर्म तासीर है सूखे हुए अदरक की, जिसको हम सौंठ भी कहते हैं, तो वो उनके लिए अच्छा है। कई लोग जो है सर्दियों में उसको बनाते हैं, तो कई लोग उसको बनाते हैं, तो फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ आई टॉक अबाउट माई सेल्फ, सो आई रियली डू नॉट अप्रिशिएट बिकॉज माई प्रकृति इज अ मोर ऑफ अ प्रीडोमिनेंस ऑफ पित्तज प्रकृति, सो आई गेट अ प्रॉब्लम विद दिस, वेयर एज समबडी फ्रॉम माई फैमिली हु इज मोर ऑफ अ कफज प्रकृति, दे इजिली हैव इट, so they have no problem in it and they really enjoy it and their body is comfortable with it, so there is a difference when we understand and have these things and our body gives us a response to this, okay, so these are the things they can really put up in their diet. Then foods to be reduced by kafaj prakriti, all the sweet things, sugars, they can reduce that because definitely their body is already prone to gain a lot of weight and heaviness, so they can just avoid that. Butter, ghee and milk in a very very moderation, then shakarkandi ya sweet potato, then fruits such as bananas, and then you have jackfruit. A lot of sweet beverages should be avoided and very very less quantity should be taken. Along with that, freshly prepared gud also should be very very reduced, and they can have gud which is an aged gud, that would be good for them. So okay, now we have understood what is good and bad for a particular prakriti. I would also like to throw some light upon what a particular prakriti is prone to develop a particular disease, because it is very important if we understand that my pittaj prakriti is prone to develop a particular kind of a disease, so that I can really abstain from some things and have a real conscious effort to avoid those diseases. So if I talk about Vataj Prakriti people, they might just develop liver problems and liver cirrhosis. So liver cirrhosis is basically wherein some kind of lesions are formed in the liver. So mostly, but this disease is mostly common to the alcoholic. So need not to worry. It depends upon the diet which you take. So this can be there. Then Alzheimer's disease, that is forgetting things very very soon, that is also very prone to them. Type 2 diabetes also is quite common to such people, so they can really, because you know type 2 is a lifestyle related, you can really really control this. Chronic renal failure, then atherosclerosis, that means there is a hardening of the arteries is there, and there is a lot of tendency of depositing plaque to it. So that is also coffee, much of a predominant, or it is much prone in such prakriti people. Osteoporosis, development of pores in the bones, right? And osteoporosis, though it is with age, it is common and it develops, but if it is at an early stage, then definitely Vataj Prakriti has a role to play in that. Then Vataj Prakriti people also might be suffering from backache, joint aches, cracking joints and things like that. Pains, and pain is a major, you know, a constituent or a major factor for Vataj Prakriti people. And also depression. So these are the things you can just keep in mind, and you can just watch yourself that you do not develop these. Pittaj Prakriti, mostly heart diseases, metabolic syndromes, that is metabolism gets disturbed. It might just also relate to thyroidism, hypothyroidism or hyperthyroidism. Another is osteoporosis again, then depression, a lot of acidity, generation of a lot of gastric ulcers, which is there. And again, liver cirrhosis might just also be. Then you have Kafaj Prakriti, they are also very prone to develop atherosclerosis, that is development or a deposition of plaque in the arteries. And again, it further leads to heart diseases also, definitely, because a particular artery is blocked, then it would lead to heart disease and blood pressure. And with blood pressure, a number of certain things are also alongside the web of a disease basically gets created, right? So another is Alzheimer's. Type 2 diabetes, COPD is another thing which wherein chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, there is a difficulty in breathing, right? So related to the respiratory system, the asthma and other problems are also quite common in such people. Obesity is very common, and if the diet is not controlled, it is out of it is out of your reach to control it. So that is very important in such prakriti people to control. And lastly, the metabolic syndrome, again related to the hormones, and chronic renal failure. So these are just this is not the entire list. this is just a very, very brief list to give you an idea that this particular, these type of diseases might just arise due to this particular, a particular person's prakriti. So one can just be aware of it and just protect themselves. This is a very simple thing to understand, and therefore I just incorporated it. If you can just see, there is a word written, aggravated by and suppressed by. So whatever food we eat, there are different rasas in food. There are six rasas basically, shadras, madhur, amla, lavan, katu, tikt, kashay. So in six rasos, there will be some rasas that will aggravate karte hain और बात को सप्रेस करते हैं. मतलब कि कटु तिक्त कषाय रस जो है, जिन भी चीजों में कटु रस या तिक्त रस या कषाय रस, एस्ट्रिंजेंट होता है कषाय वाला रस, ठीक है, और तिक्त होता है तीखा, या जो है तिक्त तीखा होता है, और कटु होता है बिटर, ठीक, तो ऐसे वाली चीजें, और मधुर हमें पता है मीठा, अम्ल जो है सार, एंड लवन सॉल्टी. तो जो ये तीनों रस है वो उसको सप्रेस करेंगे, वेरस जो कटु तिक्त कषाय है वो ऐसी चीज को बढ़ाएंगे. सिमिलरली जो पित्तज व्यक्ति है उसमें अग्रवेट होगा अगर वो अम्ल, लवण और कटु रस वाली चीजें ज्यादा यूज करते हैं. अम्ल में जैसे आ गया आपका आंवला, लवण में जो है सॉल्ट आ गया, सॉल्टी चीजें आ गई, और कटु में अगर मैं इसका एग्जांपल देना चाहूँ तो इसमें मिर्च या लाल मिर्च या ऐसा कुछ कटु में आ सकता है. वेरस अगर हम बात करें मधुर रस की, मधुर हम सब जानते हैं मीठा, देन तिक्त रस का एग्जाम्पल हो सकता है जैसे नीम हो गया, है ना, एंड कषाय रस का हो सकता है समथिंग विच हैज एन एस्ट्रिंजेंट, जैसे इमली हो गया या नींबू हो गया, है ना, बट नींबू में भी अगेन अम्ल रस भी है उसमें, ठीक है. तो ये सारे एग्जाम्पल्स हैं, और इससे आपको इस पर्टिकुलर चीज से भी आपको आइडिया लग सकता है कि आपको कौन सी चीज जो है वो फायदा करेगी, और कौन सा जो रस है किसी भोजन में वो आपको जो है उस चीज को और ज्यादा एग्रेवेट कर सकता है. एंड लास्टली कफज प्रकृति व्यक्ति में मधुर अम्ल लवण जो है उसको प्रिडोमिनेटली बढ़ाएंगे, और अगर कफज प्रकृति व्यक्ति को जो है अपने कफ को कम रखना है, उस गुण को कम करना है, तो कटु तिक्त और कषाय वाले रस वाली चीजों को ज्यादा खाना चाहिए उनको. सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द थिंग्स और द बेसिक प्रिंसिपल्स आई वुड लाइक टू शेयर. एंड लास्टली बैलेंस इज द की टू एवरीथिंग. व्हाट वी डू, think, say, eat, feel, they all require awareness, and through this awareness we can grow. So this growth is not just the physical or a mental growth, it is also an intellectual growth. So I thank you everyone for being there, and these are the references I had used during preparation of this particular presentation, and thank you so much. And everybody is most welcomed for any questions if you have. I would be more than delighted to answer anything. So there are a few questions in the chat box, and I would like to take those questions now. There were few points wherein I chose the nearest option, but it's not right as option was not there. Okay. Sumit sir, you can again relook at this list. I would be sharing this presentation, and you can relook, and then you can again evaluate yourself. Okay, and can you please explain about sleep pattern again? And excellent presentation, thank you so much sir. Okay, if I talk about the sleep pattern again, I can give you some points regarding this. The Vataj people, kind of a sleep which they have, they find themselves flying also. उनको लगता है वो एक जगह से दूसरी जगह फ्लाई कर रहे हैं सपनों में. तो इस तरह के सपने उनको आते हैं, और मोस्टली उनको जो है एयर से रिलेटेड या आकाश से रिलेटेड उनको सपने आते हैं. एंड उनकी जो स्लीप है वो बहुत ही ज्यादा कच्ची नींद होती है, और वो ज्यादा नहीं गहरी नींद, और बहुत ज्यादा लंबे समय तक नहीं सोते. तो ये वातज प्रकृति है. पित्तज प्रकृति वालों को हो सकता है फायर दिखे, गर्मी दिखे, आग दिखे सपने में. वेरेज कफज प्रकृति वाले बहुत ही गहरी नींद सोते हैं, ज्यादा सो सकते हैं, और उनकी पीसफुल, और एक आप कह लीजिए कि उनकी गहरी नींद या तम गुण से ज्यादा जो प्रेडोमिनेंट नींद है वो रहती है. सो आई थिंक आई हैव आंसर टू दैट क्वेश्चन. प्रभात निगम सर, प्लीज गिव सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ सिक्स रसा फूड्स. ओके, षड रस. ओके, इसके साथ ही एक और चीज मैं आप सबको अगर बता दूं कि सबसे अच्छा फ्रूट जो कि आजकल अब सर्दियों में भी होने वाला है, दैट इज आंवला. आंवला एक ऐसा फ्रूट है जो कि पंच रस गुण है. दैट मींस इसमें मधुर, सिर्फ एक लवण नहीं होता है इसमें, तो अगर आप नोटिस करें बहुत सारे लोग जो है नमक के साथ भी थोड़ा थोड़ा नमक लगा के आंवले को यूज करते हैं, तो नमक के साथ आने से ये पूरा षड रस युक्त हो जाता है। तो आंवला आप जरूर यूज करें सभी लोग, इट इज गुड फॉर एवरीथिंग एंड इट इज षड रस ऑल्सो। एंड द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ सिक्स रसा फूड्स वुड बी, सर एक और चीज मैं बता दूं, कई चीजें रस में मधुर होती हैं मीठी, लेकिन उसका जो विपाक है मतलब जो उसके बाद पाचन होना है, उसके बाद उसको जो चीज बनता है, जो रस पचने के बाद भी बनता है, जो कि बॉडी में हमारे जो है वेरियस स्रोतस में फ्लो करके जो है अब्सॉर्ब होता है, उसे विकास विपाक कहते हैं। तो कुछ चीजें टेस्ट में जो मीठा है उसे रस कहते हैं, और जो उसके बाद डाइजेशन के बाद जो उसका एंड प्रोडक्ट रह गया उसे विपाक कहते हैं। तो उन दोनों में भी बहुत फर्क होता है। तो हो सकता है कुछ चीजें रस में मधुर हो लेकिन उसका जो विपाक है वो कटु हो, है ना, तो ये भी फर्क है। लेकिन अगर मैं आपको एग्जाम्पल देना चाहूँ, जैसे आपने मुझसे एग्जाम्पल्स की बात की है, तो ओके आई मीन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ फूड्स ऑफ सिक्स रसास, ओके मधुर रस का हो गया ऑल दीज फ्रूट्स जो मीठे हैं, ठीक है जी, मधुर रस। अमल लवण जो है वो सारा सॉल्ट वाला हो गया, नमक को ही आप लवण ले लें, ठीक है। मधुर अम्ल, अम्ल में आ गए आपके सारे ही जो सिट्रस फ्रूट्स हैं वो अम्ल आ गए, ठीक है, मधुर अम्ल लवण। कटु में आ गए जो आपके तीखे हैं, तीखे जैसे मिर्च हो गया, वो एक कटु का रिप्लाई है। तिक्त आ गए आपके, जैसे कि तिक्त रस होता है हमारे पास, जैसे नीम है, जैसे करेला है ना, ये तिक्त रस वाले हैं। और कषाय रस होता है जैसे कि हनी का है, जो शहद होता है वो कषाय रस वाला होता है, एस्ट्रिंजेंट टाइप का होता है, ठीक है। तो ये जो है छह के छह रसों के जो है एग्जाम्पल्स हैं। लेकिन अगेन एक और नोट इसमें कि ऐसी कोई भी चीज नहीं होती जिसमें सिर्फ एक ही रस हो, ठीक है, जैसे मैंने बट हाँ प्रिडोमिनेंस जरूर हो सकती है, जैसे कि मैंने मीठे आम की बात की, तो मीठे आम में मिठास का ज्यादा एक जो है वो प्रिडोमिनेंस होगी, लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है कि उसमें और रस नहीं होंगे। डेफिनेटली एक हायर कंटेंट जरूर होगा, लेकिन मीठा या मधुर रस उसमें ज्यादा होगा जो पका हुआ आम है। वेरज अगर उसी को हम कच्चे आम की बात करें तो उसमें जो है अम्ल रस, जो उसमें जो है खट्टास, खट्टापन जो है, खट्टा मतलब अम्ल, अम्ल कहते हैं उसको, तो वो ज्यादा उसमें प्रेडोमिनेटिंग होगा। प्रभात सर, हैव आई आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन? एंड इफ यू वांट आई कैन आल्सो पुट अ स्लाइड इन द पर्टिकुलर प्रेजेंटेशन एंड आई विल जस्ट पुट वेरियस एग्जांपल्स टू दैट शड्रस। सो एनी अदर क्वेश्चन? Prabhat sir, I'll just add that slide to this if you want me to have shadras separate items under the rasa categories, I'll do that. I have just given one example, but if you want more examples to it, I'll do that. Okay sir. Any other question? Okay, I see another question. Okay. Okay. Okay, sir. Okay. I'll do it. Okay. Also of the tasir, right? I'll also mention the tasir. But you know what the tasir would be basically, it would be जो भी आपने खाया, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैं ड्राई फ्रूट्स की बात करूं, ड्राई फ्रूट्स में कोई ज्यादा टेस्ट वाली चीज नहीं है, लेकिन उनकी तासीर मतलब कि जब वो डाइजेस्ट हो गया उसकी कैलोरीफिक वैल्यू जो है वो ज्यादा है, कैलोरीज ज्यादा है उसकी, मतलब कि वो कैलोरीज एक तो ज्यादा देता ही देता है हमें, सेकेंडली वो हीट जनरेट करता है हमारी बॉडी में, तो वो ज्यादा गर्म तासीर की चीज हो गई। आई विल ऑल्सो गिव एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ फ्यू थिंग्स ओवर देयर। ओके सर, thank you so much. If you have liked this presentation, and even if the slightest of could be used to you, and you know you can really really use it for your benefit and use it into a day-to-day practice to just analyze before eating something and just analyzing what would be the best for you. So I think we all can abstain from a number of diseases, and we can really be in a good health and a good life also, because as I mentioned in the very start, what is the basic purpose of having a good swasthya? good swasthya mainly is for attaining moksha. So if you have a good healthy mind and a body, you can definitely attain a lot of things in life. So that is basic purpose of having a good health. Okay, I think thank you so much, and thank you for so many compliments and appreciating my work. And I'm really, I'm obliged that I got this opportunity to share my viewpoints. And while I was preparing, I just thought what could be, because during my 5.5 years of course, I thought what would it be which is of real benefit to all and something which can be really, really, good to grasp at a really very, very less time frame which we had. So if you've been able to understand and you think it is really beneficial for you, it is my achievement. And thank you so much for joining in for this session. And thank you so much, Chitkara University, and for this idea of VC lecture series, so that we can really come up with some different ideas and some different sharing of knowledge at this platform. So I'm really grateful for that as well. And with this, I would like to end. And thank you so much for being there and joining in today. Thank you.